The Great Recession triggered a resurgence of short-time work. These are schemes that are aimed at avoiding dismissal, so adjustment along the extensive margin in which employers do reduce the workforce by forcing people to be unemployed. These schemes were significantly expanded in a number of countries, and also their scope in terms of types of workers who could possibly be involved in these schemes was also increased. In some countries, up to 5% of the labor force was involved in these schemes. And Paul Krugman, writing a very influential op-ed on the New York Times, stressed that these schemes could explain why, in countries as Germany, the decline in employment throughout the Great Recession was much more moderate than in the US. Together with Herbert Brücker, we have been looking at the effect of short-time work throughout the Great Recession. We carried out our analysis in two steps. The first one is a theoretical part, and the second one is an empirical section. As far as theory is concerned, we did analyze the role of short-time work in combination with other labor market institutions. And our main conclusion are as follows. First of all, we believe that short-time work is meant to have a larger effect in presence of relatively strict employment protection legislation, that is, cost of dismissal for employer. Secondly, short-time work should instead be less important in countries having relatively generous unemployment benefits that promote more adjustment along the extensive margins. We do test this prediction of the model by looking at take-up rate as a function of institution in the different countries, and we do indeed find that there is stronger demand for these schemes in countries where the cost of dismissal are higher and where there is more decentralized wage bargaining. Based on a variety of data, basically data being produced by the OECD, together with micro data for Germany, we also looked at the impact of these schemes on employment and employment adjustment. We found that short-time work did indeed contribute to save jobs, but this effect is present only when we observe relatively large shocks. For mild recession, short-time work may not be the appropriate instrument, while it works well during very deep recessions, like indeed the Great Recession. At the same time, however, there are important design features of short-time work that make these schemes more effective in containing job losses. In particular, it is very important that the scheme is temporary, rather than supporting structural adjustment and freezing de facto workers for a long time in this situation in which they work less hours in a firm. These schemes should only address the very pressing needs of an employer facing an acute but relatively short-lived demand shortage. At the same time, it is very important that the hours reduction never goes down all the way to zero. The worker should still be working somehow in the firm, should still keep a foothold in the firm, working some hours during the day. All these design features are crucial. For this reason, it is not so important, as sometimes has been advocated, to extend these schemes everywhere in different countries, but it is very important to look at the details of this institution. As always, the devil is in the details.